So that's how we familiar. Them Crip niggas down there used to ride down on us, and we used to ride down on them.
Real life street stars. We are the streets. Make sure you ring that bell and subscribe to get the latest interviews and music videos.
What does OG mean to you?
Good question. OG to me mean a nigga man that can stand on his own motherfucking two. Don't gotta ask a nigga for shit. And if you do, hey man, ain't nothing wrong with help. It's an OG to me is being a man when you supposed to be standing up for what you believe in, doing for your family, doing for the kids, doing for the bitch, doing for the kids that ain't yours, doing for the bitch that you don't fuck with, might be your ex, your homeboy might need some help. You know, stand up for him. But hey man, y'all don't use my kindness for weakness. You hear me?
What does the OG look
like? Yeah. OG ain't got no motherfucking color. Black, white, tall, skinny, small. They come in all different shapes and sizes, and they come in all motherfucking me color. OG is just being real with yourself.
Can a young nigga be OG?
You goddamn right. My brother never calling me an OG at 21. My big brother Joe doing fed time right now. You know what I'm saying? My big brother Slow Joe, OG gangster Slow Joe. You know what I'm talking about? You know, but it's like he told me at 25, when I turned 24, 25, he texted me, man, and he was like, bro, happy birthday. You know, you at OG age. But he said, your status, your work, you been an OG, nigga, young, nigga, you been riding. You been doing it, you been handling your business. I ran away at 13, homie. I ran away at 13, and my mama vouched for that. And I bought my first car at 14. You know, my nigga Mushy, man, sent me to Village Joe. I bought, it was a number job, I didn't know. You know, the nigga know who sold it to me. Shout out to you, nigga, Village Joe, but I ain't mad at you, nigga. But anyway.
So, yeah, it begs the question, where are you from? Like,
I mean, it's like, where I'm from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, man. Okay. Cause that what raised me, man. Okay. That where I raised it.
That's he got the Dolphins.
Yeah, man, that what I wore this for, man, because I'm letting a nigga know, this is my roots, dog. My mama from Trinidad and Tobago. You know, I was born in Mississippi, Jackson State Hospital. When I was born, we moved to Fort Lauderdale as a baby, and did what raised me, man. I ran the streets of Fort Lauderdale, deep side. You know, to my 19th court by the dead end, Lauderdale Hills. You understand me? 56. You understand me? 55th. You know, to my Sunrise Boulevard. You know, to my Oakland Park. You know what I'm saying? By the farm store. You know what I'm talking about? Mission Lake. Yeah, this what raised me. But then I got my stripes from the D. When my mama came to Dallas, you know what I'm saying? I came 2 years later after her, man. And this is where I been, man. Dallas, Garland, back and forth. All over. The earth is my turf. You know what I'm talking
about? You feel like you could claim to know Dallas and also be from Florida?
You motherfucking right. I done put in work in North Dallas. I done got work put in on me in North Dallas. I done robbed, stealing. You know, in North Dallas, you know what I'm saying? I done did all type of shit, gangbang in Garland, you know, and then let me set the record straight about that shit. Yeah, I'm from Garland, nigga, West Wildnut. Yeah, nigga, neighborhood Piru, nigga. Yeah, some Cali nigga, some LA nigga, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I ain't gonna say nothing, but the big homies know who they are, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, I used to bang a whole bunch of shit, still banging that shit. Neighborhood Piru didn't stop. And it just started in Garland, and that shit bled on down. And that's how I got familiar with the Crook. The Crook in my neighborhood coming out of Garland is on the same street, West Wildnut. West Wildnut. That same street go down to North Dallas. Cross Jupiter, cross Plano Road, all the way to motherfucking Adelia. So that's how we familiar. Them Crip niggas down there used to ride down on us, and we used to ride down on them. You dig what I'm saying? And for a while, that's what it was, but until we got a little older and niggas start being about that bag, it was like, hey man, we in North Dallas. Then a lot of us from Garland got ran out of Garland due to some criminal activities that we did, participated in. You dig, the laws ran us out. So you know, North Dallas was the next best thing right next door. So my homeboy, I got a lot of homeboys from North Dallas before I came from Garland to North Dallas. Then you gotta think, before it got wet around here with liquor and brew. Wasn't no liquor and brew in Garland. When you had to go get liquor and brew, nigga, you had to come out of Garland and go to Dallas. So of course, nigga, we gonna migrate and fuck with some niggas out of Dallas. I was fucking with a bunch of niggas out of North, out of Project. You know, bunch of niggas out the grow. I know niggas from everywhere, you know.
Shout out Reality Street Stars, nigga. Moving. Hey.